So, I think I'm discussing about your expecting value of aggregate. So, aggregate object expecting value. So, we can have point of discussion. Stripping. Value. Okay. So you all just see here. So basically, this is our stripping value test of bitumen. So just what is a stripping value test? So the stripping value of aggregate is determined as the ratio of uncovered area observed visually to the total area of aggregate surface as a percentage. So bitumen and tar adhere well to all normal type of aggregate provided they are dry and they are not exceptionally dusty. So this problem of stripping is experienced only with bituminous mixture which are permeable to water. This test gives the procedure for determination of the stripping value of aggregate by static immersion method when bitumen and tar binders are used. So just to wait. Just wait. So basically, the stripping value of aggregate is determined as the ratio of uncovered area observed visually to the total area of aggregate expressed as a percentage. So bitumen and tar adhere well to all normal type of aggregate provided them they are not exceptionally dusty. So the aggregate on which we have to find the stripping value. We first see what we do. I think I already discussed in your last two session. So the problem of stripping is experienced only with your bituminous mixture which are permeable to water. So this test gives the procedure for determination of the stripping value of aggregates by static immersion method when bitumen and tar binder are used. So I already said how to define this stripping value test. So here our aim is to determine the stripping value of road aggregate by binders. So apparatus required for this test. So the apparatus required for this experiments are your thermostatically controlled water bath, oven to heat aggregate, sieves of size 20 mm and 12.5 mm, beaker of 50 mL capacity, mixture to mix aggregate and bitumen. So you all see here. Just wait. Yeah. You all see. So this stripping value test is basically used to check, because we know generally aggregates are used on road construction and also we use our bitumen for our road construction. So basically from stripping value of aggregate, we generally check how much of our aggregate will stirrup with that bitumen, or how much aggregate will be covered with our bitumen. So the stripping value of aggregate is determined as the ratio of uncovered area observed visually to the total area of aggregates expressed as a percentage. So basically, aggregate we basically take a certain amount of. So we just take. So here we see we take the aggregates and from the that aggregates we check how much of that aggregate will stir up with that bitumen. So how much of bitumen will attract with that aggregate? So for testing we just take 200 gram of aggregate and we try to adhere or we try to give our bitumen and tar to stir up with that aggregate. So bitumen and tar adhere well to all normal type of aggregate provided they are dry and are not exceptionally dusty. So basically we first before testing this stripping value test we just clean bitumen and tar from water and also we dry that aggregates which will be used in this test. So this is all about our primary part. So bitumen and tar adhere well to all normal type of aggregates provided they are dry and not exceptionally dusty. So basically we use that bitumen and tar which will adhere the aggregate in well form and also provide that aggregate as dry. So this problem is stripping in experience only with bituminous mixture which are permeable to water. So the problem of stripping is generally experienced when the aggregate have permeable property. So this test gives the procedure for determination of stripping value of aggregate by static immersion method when bitumen and tar binders are used. So here you see you have only aggregate. So here you see you have only aggregates. So here you have only aggregate and a small portion of bitumen. So it is this is before the test and this is your after the testing. So basically here our coarse aggregate is adhere with this bitumen. So here we have two mixture. First figure showing that before test our bitumen is uncovered on that aggregate and second figure will say our bitumen will covered on our aggregate. So these are the apparatus which we use in this testing. I already discussed thermometric mechanically controlled water bath oven to heat aggregate sieves of size 20 mm to 125 mm each used. So these are basically procedure. So these are different apparatus which we required for the test. So the apparatus required for this experiments are thermostatically controlled water bath, oven to heat aggregate, sieves of size 20 mm and 12.5 mm. Beaker of your 50 mm capacity, mixture to mix aggregate and bitumen. Next. So these are our apparatus used. So this is the procedure. First procedure is 200 gram of clean and dry aggregate passing 20 mmI sieve. So basically we use that aggregate which is passing from 200 gram. We take 200 gram of clean and dry aggregate which is passing from 20 mmI sieve and retain on 12.5 mm sieve. So basically we take that aggregate which is passing from 20 mmI sieve but retain on 12.5 mmI sieve. So this aggregate is taken and the weight of that aggregate is 200 gram and the aggregate is heated at a temperature of 150 degrees Celsius. When these are to be mixed with bitumen. So basically what we do, the aggregate which is used in this test is passing through 20 mm ice sieve and retained on 12.5 mm sieve and heating up to 150 degrees Celsius when these are mixed with bitumen. So bitumen binder amounting to 5% by weight of aggregate is heated to 156 degrees Celsius. So basically bitumen binder is taken to 5% by weight of aggregate and heated up to 160 degrees Celsius. The aggregate and binders are mixed thoroughly till they are completely coated. So basically the aggregate and binder are here mixed thoroughly till they are completely coated. That means they all are, that means the binder, the bitumen binder which we use in this test will cover all the portion of aggregate and mixture is turned to the beaker. Then we kept all the mixture, we take all the mixture and transfer to the beaker and allow that mixture to cool at room temperature for about 2 hours. So basically what we do, we just allow our all the mixture to cool at room temperature for 2 hours. So next is distilled water is then added to immerse the coated water. So after two hours, the coated coarse aggregate is filled by distilled water. So basically distilled water is then added to immerse the coated aggregate. So what we do, first we take our aggregate and we try to pass that aggregate from our 20 mm ISC. Then what we do? First we take a sieve of size 20 mm and also 12.5 mm. We first pass that aggregate from 20 mm ISC and see how much of aggregate in retain on 12.5 mm sieve. So from that aggregate, we just separate out 200 gram of aggregate. Then we clean that aggregate and also dry that aggregate in an oven, or we just heat that aggregate up to a temperature of 150 degrees Celsius, which will given in procedure first. So when these are mixed with bitumen, because these aggregates are mixed with our bitumen, and here we mix our binder in that aggregate. So we first clean and dry our bitumen. Next, bitumen binder amounting to 5% by weight of aggregate is heated to 160 degrees Celsius. So basically what we do here, we use also bitumen binder. So bitumen binder, the amount of bitumen binder which we use in this test is 5% by weight of aggregate. So here we take for 200 gram of aggregate. So here 5% of 200 gram is how much? So here we take 5% of 5% of 5% of 200 gram. So how much is the result? So 5 by 100 into 200. So here just divide it with 2. So here we get 10 gram. So here we get 10 gram. So we take 10 gram bitumen binder for this test and we heat that binder up to a temperature of 160 degrees Celsius. Now what we do? The aggregate and binder are mixed thoroughly till they are completely coated. So we just mix all the binder, aggregate with binder in such a manner that all the aggregates will completely mix with that binder. Then what we do, a mixture of binder and aggregate is ready. Then we transfer that mixture to the beaker. So we take a beaker and we all transfer all this mixture to the beaker, and just allow this mixture to cool at a room temperature for about 2 hours. Then, if our mixture be cool at room temperature for about 2 hours, then we add distilled water into that that mixture. That means in that coated aggregate. Then what we do? Then just see here. Then what we do? Just wait. So the beaker is covered. So the beaker on which the mixture is transferred is covered from top and kept in water bath. And we put that whole mixture in a water bath, and the temperature of water bath maintained at a 40 degrees Celsius, 40 degrees Celsius for 24 hours. So after 24 hours, the beaker is taken out. So you all see here, after 24 hours, the beaker is taken out. The beaker is taken out, cool at room temperature, and the extent of stripping is estimated visually while the specimen is still under water. So what we do after 24 hour, beaker is taken out. So we just taken out a beaker from our water bath and cool at room temperature, and we allow that beaker to cool out at room temperature, and the strain and the extent of stripping is estimated visually while the specimen is still under water. So just we see how much of bitumen will stir up that aggregate. It will be seen from our naked eye. So when our beaker is taken out, so what we do when the beaker is taken out from water bath, then after 24 hour from visual inspection, we see how much of our bitumen will remove or will stir off that aggregates. So here you see, so this is our apparatus on which we do mixing. So here you all have see 4 glass. So here you all see we have 4 beakers, 1 beaker, 2 beaker, 3 beaker, and 4 beakers. So in all the beakers we put our aggregates and bitumen, and from here, these are our 4 beakers. So here we have 1 beaker. Here we have, I use another mark. So here we have 1 beaker. Here we have another beaker. Here we have another beaker. Here we have another beaker. So we have 4 beakers. So in these 4 beakers, we just keep our all the aggregates and all the bitumen. And from here we start. Here we start mixing that whole apparatus. So I think, is it clear? Next, this whole setup will rotate with 360 by giving the current. So until full mixing of aggregate and bitumen, be allowed to rotate that drum from unlimited time. So we take time and we note that time to mix whole aggregate and bitumen completely. So test apparatus to mix bitumen and apparatus. So the result is reported here. You all see the result is reported. Just wait. The result is reported as the percentage of stone surface. The result is reported as the percentage of stone surface that remains coated. That means So that means we check how much of aggregate will remain coated and after the specified period. So here we see the percentage of a stone, the percentage of aggregate that has not been coated after the specified periods, the mean value of at least 3 visual estimate value being rounded off to the nearest 5% by visual inspection stream value of road is given as this much of percentage. So specification, we have next specification. So what we do? So just wait. So here what we do, we just take the aggregate and also we check three values for estimating or for giving stripping value of road aggregate. So a specification is Indian Road Congress has specified the maximum stripping value as 5% for aggregate to be used in bituminous construction like surface trussing, penetration macadam and bituminous macadam and carpet. So next is our application of a stripping value test. So just see here, what are the application of stripping value test? Sometimes some types of aggregates have a lesser affinity with hypnotic in comparison with water. And hence the stripping value of the bituminous binder is done when the mix is emergent water. The problem of stripping is coated aggregate is not so amenable to theoretically treatment. Thus, an addition test such as simple stripping test would be suitable to assess whether the binder would adhere to the aggregate when immersed in water. Several anti-stripping agents are available, which when used with the bituminous mix reduce the stripping. So I think these are all about your stripping value. So just wait. What do we do? We have tested all the tests of your aggregate. So you know what we do. In aggregate testing, we perform our crushing value test. Crushing value test. Next is your impact test. Next is your impact test. Next is your hardness test, next is your hardness test. Next is your soundness test. Next is your sap test. And last one is your stripping test. So I've discussed all the type of test for your aggregate stripping value test. Stripping value test. So what do you mean by crushing strength test? Crushing strength test, basically in crushing strength test we check the strength of our aggregate. So in crushing strength test, the aggregate crushing value gives the relative measure of the resistance of an aggregate to crushing under a gradually applied compressive load. With aggregates of aggregate crushing value 30 or higher, the result may be taken also it will be given by our IRC. So aggregate crushing value is basically defined as the percentage, basically the aggregate crushing value gives a relative measure of the resistance of an aggregate to crushing under a gradually applied compressive load or crushing load. So aggregate crushing value is defined as the percentage by weight of the crushed or finer material obtained when the test aggregates are subjected to a specified load under strength-rich conditions, and the strength of aggregate used in road construction is expressed by numerical index. Next, basically I discuss objective of crushing strength test is that to determine the crushing value of aggregate for road aggregates, to determine the suitability of aggregate for use in different type of road pavements, and basically I also discuss the apparatus for standard aggregate crushing test as per your IS 2386 1963 part 4, which basically first your balance, the capacity of balance is 5 kg, ISC box size 12.5 mm, 10 mm and 2.36 mm is used. A compressive testing machine capable of applying load up to 40 tons at a uniform rate of 4 tons per minute. A cylindrical measure having an internal diameter of 11.5 cm and height 18 cm. A straight metal tempering rod of circular cross section of 16 mm diameter and 45 to 60 centimeter long, rounded at one end, and also be used a test mod of diameter 15.2 centimeter open ended steel cylinder, and its base is square, and also a plunger is used having a piston of diameter 15 centimeter. A rod could be inserted for lifting or pressing the plunger in the cylinder with a provided hole across the stem of the plunger. So we do this test in your previous classes. So we give a table for type of roads and also aggregate crushing value not more than the, just here we have different types of road. Here we have different types of road, and here we have aggregate crushing value not more than. So if we have flexible payment, you already know we have flexible payment. So just see here. If we discuss about FP, that means this is our flexible payment. Flexible payment have basically four layers. So basically flexible payments have four layers. First is your surface course. And next is your base course. Next is your sub base course, SBC. And last one is your subgrade, SG. So basically, so here we have flexible payment, and we know flexible payment have different layers. Here we have rigid payment. Here if you see, we have another payment, that is your rigid payment. So for rigid payment, for RP, I think for rigid payment, you have only three layers. You have top layer. You have only, here is your subgrade. Here we have sub base course, and here we have surface course. And in surface course, generally in flexible payment we use bitumen. So in flexible payment we generally use bitumen, but in rigid payment we use cement concrete on the top surface. And also here if you see in flexible payment, we use four layers. Here we have one layers, here we have another layer, here we have another layer, and here we have another layer. But in rigid payment we have only three layers, 1, 2, and 3. So we have only 1, 2, and 3. Here we have 1, 2, 3, and 4. So here one layer is missing. So here one layer is missing, that is your base course. So just remember this point, that in your rigid payment base course is not present. So here we have different types of road. So just here you observe, we have different type of road. So just wait, this is our flexible payment. And this is aggregate pressing value, not more than. So first is your flexible payment is of soling. So your aggregate pressing value should not be more than 50. So your aggregate pressing value should not be more than 50. Next is your waterborne macadam. So basically in first topic I already said that we have different road construction. First one is your Roman road construction. Next one is your trestle guard road construction. Next is your metagraph road construction. Next is your Telford road construction. And last one is your macadam road construction. And macadam is the person who gives a technical point of view about road construction. So basically here we have huge waterborne macadam, and also the crushing aggregate crushing value of waterborne macadam should not be more than 40. Next is your bituminous macadam. That means here we use water. Here we, for making construction road or for making or binding the aggregates, we use water. So this is generally used in village roads. Waterborne macadam is generally used in your village roads. Next is your bituminous macadam. So here for bituminous macadam, aggregate crushing value should not be more than 40. Next is your bituminous surface dressing or thin permix carpet. So basically for bituminous surface dressing or thin permix carpet, the aggregate crushing value should not be more than 30. And last one is dense mix carpet. So for dense mix carpet, our aggregate crushing value should not be more than 30. and different type of road construction is our frigid pavement. So you all see here, we have three layers of frigid pavement. We have top surface, that is known as surface course. Next is your sub-base course, and last one is your subgrade. So for frigid pavement, other than the bearing course, surface or bearing course, we have different aggregate crushing value, and the aggregate crushing value should not be more than 45 for other than bearing course, and surface or bearing course aggregate crushing value should not be more than 30. So these are all about your crushing value test. So I think I show you all something. So just wait. Basically, if you see here, we have aggregate crushing value test. We have here base plate, here is cylinder, here is your piston, here is your plunger, and here is your cylindrical measure, steel tempering rods. So if you see here the figure, I think here is the complete picture. So this is aggregate crushing strength value in your laboratory is determined from this testing machine. So this is basically your aggregate crushing strength value testing machine, checking testing machine. So this is your immersion testing machine, and here we give a load of 40 ton for basically 10 minutes. So every minute we give 4 ton of loading. So this is all about your crushing value test. So this is completed. This is completed. Also, I complete this impact test. So basically, in impact test and in crushing value test, we check the strength of our aggregate. In impact test, we check the toughness of our aggregate, because in impact testing machine, we give impact from our hammer on the aggregate. So if we see the impact of our hammer on that aggregate is more than the quality of that aggregate is very cheap or very poor. So we do not use that type of aggregates for making our road construction or for making our pavement construction. Next is your hardness test. So for performing hardness test, we check abrasion value of our aggregate, or we take Los Angeles testing machine and double abrasion or double attrition testing machine for testing of our aggregate hardness. Next is your soundness test. So for soundness test, we just see how much of aggregate will get weathered from different chemicals, and for testing we use different chemicals like sodium sulfate and magnesium sulfate. So basically what we do, we just put our sodium sulfate and magnesium sulfate on aggregate, and we put aggregate for a particular, I think for 16 to 18 hours in that chemical. So after 16 to 18 hours, we take out that chemical, that aggregate from that chemical, and allow to dry that aggregate. Then we see some of the aggregate will get weathered from that chemical. So from that manner, we check the soundness of our aggregate, and we find how much of our aggregate will get weathered. Next is your SIP test. So I think in today's session, I also discuss and show the video of SIP test of your own laboratory, and also I think in some class I also share the video of your impact testing of your own laboratory, where I think Pita madam show you all the video of your impact testing. Next is your SIP test. So basically SIP test is also performed to check the shape of aggregate, and here we see for checking the shape test of aggregate, we use the help of angularity number, and also we use the help of our multi number and what left, and also we take the help of our flatness index and elongation index, and also we check the take the help of your length gauge and thickness gauge and so many things. And also in today's session I discuss all about stripping value test and check how much of aggregate will left without coated to your bitumen. So I think in today lab session I discuss all the test which will be related with our aggregates. So basically up to this point we cover this test in detail, and also I summarize all the test in detail. And also I summarize you all this all the test in detail. So this is all about your test for aggregates. So in next class I am discuss different test, and I also start the test which we perform on our basically bitumen. So here I end our session. Thank you. Thank you, everyone.